you have a mower, the 25 horsepower Briggs & Stratton engine on it. This is about the worst air cleaner arrangement I've ever seen. Especially in the fall, you're mulching leaves. There's a cloud of leaf dust in that comes up here. It goes straight in this air cleaner. And goes right into this air filter. This is a small filter. There's very little clearance between this and this housing. And this pre-filter plugs up. This whole thing will plug up in just a matter of minutes. And then if this starts bypassing, you're sucking all that junk into the engine. So I'm going to endeavor to replace this with a Donaldson filter. This is a 48-inch Ferris. This is a 25 horsepower, two-cylinder Briggs. The air intake is here on the side. It comes in here and swirls around here. There's one of these little duckbill eliminator evacuator things here that doesn't work very well. This air filter cartridge has a foam sleeve on it. When that goes in there, that just barely fits. So that's a very thin channel for air to get into the engine. And this rubber seals on this nipple that's sticking out. I cut this rubber section off of an old air cleaner. And I'm using it inside, or I will use it inside this 3D printed part. And because this is now slightly larger in diameter, I'm giving myself a little more clearance here. And that will push in there. That rubber will again engage on that nipple. There'll be a cover on here, and that spring will hold that in place. And I will have a pipe or a nipple that will stick up through here and then connect to a proper Donaldson filter. If you order one of these mowers with a Kawasaki engine, it has a good Donaldson filter on it. Apparently Briggs or Ferris are just too lazy to set this thing up with good air filtration. But my adapter will be a marked improvement over this. I was hoping I could remove this part of this filter housing and have access to the carburetor, but that is not possible. These two are the intake manifolds from the carburetor to the cylinders, and then that carburetor is facing directly into the engine block. And behind this nipple, there is a vertical rectangular connection to the back of that carburetor. So there is no easy way to modify this Mickey Mouse filter arrangement. This is a used air cleaner out of my Briggs & Stratton engine. And I use the Milwaukee grinder to cut that wire mesh that's around here. And then just reached in with a sharp knife and cut those pleats. This sealing area pushes onto a 2-inch nipple that's inside the air cleaner housing. I wish to reuse that to seal my adapter so I can use a Donaldson air cleaner. Having cut this away, this is pretty flimsy. I wanted to reduce the diameter, but these pleats go in here pretty deep. Looks like this outside rubber is only about that thick. Really couldn't tell that until after I had this cut away. I need to true this up, make this a little flatter, and I'm going to try doing that on the sander. So now I have all the pieces made. I sanded this flat on a belt sander, and it's roughly 5/8 of an inch thick. It will be sealed in here with silicone. Put silicone around this edge here. Shove that down in there. Got another washer that'll go in there. I'm gonna put a weight on there and let that silicone set up. When that's done, then this piece will be sealed in here with, I expect to use construction adhesive if I have any, or I may use silicone again. Put that down in there and turn it and make sure everything is sealed up good and tight. Again, put a weight on that and let it set up. The way this is made, That's roughly 5/8 of an inch clearance between the bottom of this piece and the inside of this. With a little silicone on there and there's construction adhesive, and go inside these pleats on that rubber, that will make a good seal. I'll take a piece of heavy wall PVC. I'm gonna chuck that up in the lathe and turn that down to 1 3/4 so it'll fit in here. I won't do this until after the Donaldson filter is here, just to verify what size hose will actually go on there. I will seal that in here. And then this end cap goes in place. And now I will have what is equivalent of the original filter that will slide into that filter housing. That little spring clip will hold up against this. And this piece of pipe or nipple will stick up, and the Donaldson filter will attach here. I assembled this with silicone. I printed a new end cap that's about 1.5 millimeters or 2 millimeters smaller in diameter, and that now fits in there perfect. And then I took a reference from here and located the center of that hole. I removed the Briggs and Stratton sticker, put some tape on here, and then located the center of that hole and drilled that out 1 3/4. I have since opened that up to about 2 inches, and I expect to split some tubing and put it around that edge. With the nipple sticking up, then this will go down over that nipple, and that tubing will just make it a little neater. With this sealed with silicone and the assembly plugged into that nipple, there is no air leakage around here. So this opening here does not need to be airtight. This is the Donaldson filter I will be using on the mower. This is the original filter that was on the Briggs and Stratton engine. And this is the Donaldson filter. The Donaldson filter is slightly smaller in diameter, about 30% longer. The main advantage of this is that I can mount it up higher and get the air intake above ground and away from all the debris and that's coming out of the mower. Air comes in here, is caused to swirl around this thing, and hopefully centrifugal force will knock out the larger bits and pieces of material. They'll find their way down here to the bottom and go to this, what I call a rubber duck eliminator. And the pulsation of the engine running, the pistons going back and forth, and the pulsation of air that's going through the carburetor will cause this thing to open and close and expel larger bits and pieces of dirt and dust, hopefully. And this does want to remain in good condition and flexible. This is fairly stiff. This filter plugs in here. The air comes in, goes through the filter, and finds its way to the carburetor. Also available in case this filter gets worn or somehow gets a little hole poked in one of these pleats. Any fine material that might get past this, they also have what is called a safety filter that plugs into the center, and then this filter goes over it. It's a pretty nice arrangement. I split a piece of vinyl tubing to go around that opening. I tapped an existing hole in the frame for 5/16. I put a little thread lock around that, and I've got nylocks on these two bolts. This rollover protection bar was drilled and tapped for 5/16. I put some thread locker on that, and I did the same thing for this bolt that goes into this vertical square tube. When I put the air cleaner on here, this whole thing would vibrate like a tuning fork. So I had to put a support back to the rollover bar, and it still vibrated, and I had to add a little more stiffening in here. Now, that doesn't vibrate at all.